Lunedì 26 marzo 2018, presso l'hotel Royal Continental in via Partenope a Napoli, si è svolto il secondo dei tre appuntamenti organizzati per celebrare il 14° convegno internazionale Europe Road, una delle più importanti conferenze a livello mondiale nel campo dei sensori ottici per applicazioni chimiche e biochimiche, basata su di un approccio altamente multidisciplinare. La conferenza, organizzata dall'IREA, l'Istituto per il Rilevamento Elettromagnetico dell'Ambiente, dal CNR IFAC, l'Istituto di Fisica Applicata Anello Carrara, e dalla SIOF, la Società Italiana di Ottica e Fotonica, attrae fin dal 1992 scienziati e ingegneri da università, istituti di ricerca e industrie di tutte le parti del mondo. Europe Road nasce per discutere di tutti gli aspetti connessi alla ricerca, allo sviluppo e alle applicazioni chimiche dei sensori e dei biosensori. Ad aprire la conferenza i saluti del sindaco di Napoli, Luigi De Magistris.
Oltre buon lavoro nel settore di vostra competenza, augurarvi una buona permanenza nella nostra città, perché di Napoli spesso nel mondo non si ha una conoscenza approfondita. È una città complicata, una città difficile, ma è una città ricca di storie, ricca di bellezze, è una città che produce emozioni forti, come immagino camminare vicino a questo mare così intenso e così bello. E quindi mi auguro che possiate portare nel vostro cuore, nel vostro ricordo, la nostra città, che è una città internazionale, è una città piena di incontri di culture, è la città d'Europa col più alto numero di giovani. Questa è una cosa, per esempio, che non si sa, il nostro petrolio sono i giovani.
Subito dopo ha preso la parola il pluripremiato professore Itamar Wilner dell'Università Ebraica di Gerusalemme, che ha dato il via agli interventi che sono proseguiti per tutta la giornata e si sono svolti nell'auditorium e nella sala Mirabilis.
I describe basically highlights that originated from about 20 years of research in my laboratory in the field of biosensors and sensor technologies, and I have emphasized the significance for the future nanomedicine and the environmental sensing project. I mainly talked about the significance of recent advances in the field of nanomaterials. Nanomaterials provide wonderful new materials and substances for the development of sensors, and basically bridge the field of nanotechnology with sensor devices. I think that I demonstrated the recent advances that originated in this field, and mainly I emphasized the possible use of these materials for future commercialization and future perspectives of the field. In this sense, I emphasize and try to advertise the use of sense and treat systems in biomedicine. This is a totally new field with a lot of future potential that sensor entities, especially nanomaterials, will travel in our body, will detect biomarkers for certain diseases, and by command will open the carriers and to release drugs for these diseases. So one can expect that in the near future people will have autonomous robots in their body that will sense and treat certain diseases. This is not anymore an illusion, but is something that is achievable, and I hope that this will be the next phase of sensor technology and sensor applications.
Il ricercatore Paul Di Carmine dell'Università di Toronto ha trattato di monitoraggio del biossido di carbonio nel sottosuolo, dall'acqua bassa all'operazione in pozzi di osservazione profondi.
So the work that I presented today was work that my company has been working on for about 7 years to monitor carbon dioxide leaks in underground carbon dioxide storage sites. So our technology involves coating an optical fiber with a sensing material and implanting this fiber underground in a monitoring well. And with this technology, we can measure changes in carbon dioxide concentration inside the well that might result from a leak at a carbon storage and sequestration site. So it's really important to make sure that, you know, when you put carbon underground, it stays there to prevent things like climate change. So that's what our technology focuses on, is verification and monitoring that the carbon we put underground stays underground.
Il professor Aldo Roda dell'Università di Bologna ha spiegato il dispositivo microintegrato per l'amplificazione isotermica del DNA con rilevamento di bioluminescenza su chip.
I'm here for this very important event. This is an European conference on optrode, and very interesting for people working on biosensors and the sensor, any kind of instrument able to monitor in a real time, in a different situation, any kind of substance, a molecule, toxic compound, and so on. My personal experience and my talk, next talk, will be about to measure in space, in the International Space Station, the health status of astronaut. Our project that will be presented today here is a project in a collaboration between the Italian Space Agency, European Space Agency, and the NASA from the United States, and has been done recently by the astronaut Nespoli in the International Space Station. We develop and we realize a small portable device that still now is International Space Station, is in the space, but has been used by the astronaut to measure in his saliva, oral fluid, a cortisol that is one of the biomarker of stress, fatigue, that it can be run in the space. And this has been successfully achieved, the goal to measure these substances, and will be used in the future, not only in the space, but even in land, in the earth, in a critical situation, like in underdeveloped country, developed country, and in bioterrorism or critical medicine.
Dell'esposizione di sensori di ioni metallici a doppio segnale, a chemiluminescenza e fluorescenza, ha parlato lo scienziato cinese Han.
And I think this conference is very meaningful, and I learned a lot in this conference, and we can talk with each other and share with each other about the work in the chemiluminescence and the electrochemiluminescence, and I'm very happy and honored to come here.
Il chimico Lei Ye dell'Università svedese di Lund si è incentrato sui polimeri con impronta molecolare e nanoparticelle per il rilevamento ottico.
So it's a great pleasure to be here in Naples, and I'm happy to be able to be here to listen to the other experts talking about all the different subjects and so on. So it's very nice opportunity to exchange ideas and discuss scientific questions with colleagues here. The significant part of this conference is really, I'm impressed by the program, a scientific program in particular. So let's, for example, the opening plenary lecture we just heard this morning, it was given by one of my favorite speakers. So when I looked at the other part of the program, it's also highly interesting, including the special subsessions like this morning.
Maria Cruz Moreno Bondi dell'Università Complutense di Madrid si è incentrata sui biosensori ottici che utilizzano elementi di riconoscimento ricombinanti e selezionati dall'osservazione dei fagi.
This conference is one of the main ones in the area of optical sensors, so it's has lasted for many editions already, and I think that it's a place where all the researchers, not only European ones, but also from the States and from Japan, China, and many different countries working in the area, join together, and it's a very attractive conference for us.
È stata quindi la volta di Francesco Michelotti del Dipartimento di Scienze di Base Applicate per l'Ingegneria dell'Università degli Studi di Roma La Sapienza.
I think the content of the conference is very important. because it's related to personalized medicine, to so-called 4P medicine, that will make that in the future diseases will be addressed much more efficiently.
Il fisico Giampaolo Pitruzzello dell'Università di York si è dedicato al test rapido di sensibilità antimicrobica basato su intrappolamento idrodinamico.
And conferences like this are actually a great opportunity to meet other researchers in the field, in particular in the field of optical and chemical biosensors in this case. And it's always a great opportunity to get to know new ideas and new ways of approaching research in the field of biosensors, which is very crucial these days for any kind of application in the medical and environmental fields, for example. My presentation was about a novel way to assess antimicrobial resistance, which is an actual problem because bacteria are developing resistance to antibiotics, which means that the drugs and medicines we use to heal from infections, they might not be effective anymore. So we need to tackle the problem, and the way to do this is to realize rapid tests to actually assess if a bacterium is sensitive to certain antibiotics in order to inform the choice of antibiotics at the very early stages of infections.
Il dottor Ander Chapartegui Arias ha parlato del MOF, come accendere sensori ottici fluorescenti.
For me personally, it's the first time I have given a talk in a conference about my work, so it's been interesting and very difficult for me. I'm not completely happy with my performance, but it's okay, it's the first time. I'm working in developing metal organic frameworks as optical sensors against endocrine disrupting phthalates, which are toxic molecules that can be found in daily life plastics. And the end goal is, if everything goes okay, is to develop a quick and reliable methodology to determine the presence in our daily life.
A seguire l'ingegnere Cristina Ulanova dell'Institute of Photonics and Electronics CSA è passata al sondaggio di singole interazioni e dinamiche biomolecolari su scala nanometrica.
Actually, it was we are doing like primary research, which means that we are really studying the biomolecules, how they interact in our cells. So in our cells, we have microtubules, filaments, and there is lots of proteins running around them, and actually we don't know how they behave and why. And that's what was my presentation about.
Per lo scienziato Armstrong, invece, si è trattato di occuparsi di sensori plasmonici a singola proteina che utilizzano gli aptameri a DNA.
I think the conference is extremely significant. I think it's bringing together a range of people from all different fields of sensing, including biosensing, environmental sensing, toxicity sensing, and that's a really good thing because we can collaborate and use each other's ideas to make better, cheaper, more effective sensors that the world can use. In my work, I spoke about using gold nanorods to detect individual CRP proteins. CRP is a biomarker for cardiac arrest and heart disease, so we'd like to be able to monitor lower concentrations and monitor these concentrations for a long period of time. So we find that using gold nanorods is an effective way to do that.
Altro intervento di livello, quello di Chiara Schiattarella del Dipartimento di Fisica Università degli Studi di Napoli, Federico II.
For sure, the opportunity to share experience and in deep fields that are the one where I work in, and also have a look at what other researchers do, as well as making new friends. My presentation was about the study on the optical properties of silicon-based nanostructures and their use for biological applications, in particular to bioimaging.
A prendere la parola anche il professore di fisica applicata Alberto Diaspro, a capo del Dipartimento di Nanofisica dell'Istituto Italiano di Tecnologia. Di nanotecnologie applicate ha parlato anche il dottor Ramiz Ahmad, sale manager della Nanoscribe Company.
So the technology itself is actually based on two photon polymerization, so there is a femtosecond laser that gets absorbed. That is focused actually with the help of an objective in a resist where two photons get absorbed to give you an energy equivalent to UV, and there, actually, the magic takes place and the polymer turns to solid, for example, polymerizes, and then you can move this part in three dimensions to make the part of your choice. So at Nanoscribe, we are working in making small things matter.
Un contributo importante dal punto di vista dell'elettrochimica è stato offerto dal dottor Nirav Kumar Joshi.
This conference has given the wide opportunity for the PhD student, postdocs and the researcher. So basically who is working in the chemical sensors and gas sensors or biosensors. So this is a great opportunity for the researcher and to exchange their idea with the professor, with the new researcher, industry members.
A porto di rilievo anche quello del ricercatore italiano Francesco Baldini, scienziato attivo nello sviluppo di dispositivi ottici per la rivelazione di parametri chimici e biochimici da applicare nel settore biomedicale.
It's very important that in this case, for this edition, we have a very large participation of students, roughly 47-48%, so which means that half of the audience is formed by PhD student making the doctorate, so which are, let's say, the fuel of the science for the future. And together with this, there are some of the main actors at scientific level operating all over the world in this area. So that we have 5 plenary speakers plus 10 invited speakers coming, as I told before, from everywhere. And this is the first day of the conference, and it seems that everything is working well, and people are very interested and fascinated by the archive, which are for the moment considered in this part.